It is a TNL time. Good evening. Welcome to your World of Champions. It feels so good to come back. Is it the duty of the coach in the first place to be going around to the league and asking for players and really giving them the plan? Well, Matthews is here and also Tato is here. Let's go into, firstly, Sheikh Mashaba's press conference held in Pretoria.
I met Mr. Schloss, Mr. Derek Blankensee, and the young Schloss, Jonathan. We said I gave them a program, and it was still with the qualifiers. Gave them with the qualifiers. And then I gave them a program of the top eight.
All right, hardly Sheikh Mashaba had shut his mouth and left the country, and then a press conference called for 12:30 in the PSL offices today. Irvin Khoza, the chairman, surrounded by the Exco members, had this to say.
Not one disappears if we are the one that are not coming on board, and we've got an agenda which we have done everything in our power to make sure that this team gets all the support. But if we don't get these things on time, it becomes difficult for us to assist.
Swedish Footballer of the Year. I mean, you walk around with that title, you've earned it, now it's up to you to maintain it. Yeah. How do you hope to do that?
Yeah, you know, I just have to keep myself humble and keep my feet on the ground to stay focused and to do great.
What a great story tonight for Benson and Thongo. No one gave him a chance of coming back. He missed out on the World Cup. He missed out on all the excitement. His knee looked to be finished.
I saw you watch that tackle. And I saw you watch away. What is going through your mind?
Remind me of the second day from Durban to Mel Park Hospital where they say, "Eish, can you please call everyone you love that support you to come and hear the message or the results from the scan?" And I said, my wife is here. Said, "We think you should take the insurance money and quit."
He went.
So I remember.
Was that the message?
It was a message after 2 hours of scan.
Check the insurance money, and that is it for you?
Yeah, do you have insurance? Or
it brings back memories, though. I mean, sadness. I can see you tearing up. It's very emotional still.
Both sides, sadness and joy that I believed to say only I can determine my destiny in football, no one else.
Now joining us on the magical couch again, and this time around as a champion and the fourth Frenchman to have African Cup of Nations success and the first since 2004 when Roger Lemire did that, the one and only, and we bow down to him. Hev Renard, welcome back as a champion. You feel like a champion?
It's amazing for us. I'm very proud for the Zambian people. I saw when we returned in Zambia, how they were happy. Happy is not a good word. It's amazing for them. I'm sure they are so proud to be on top of Africa.
In 109 years, we've never seen a score of this nature before. And unfortunately for Australia, they got questions to ask themselves. But you know what? As South Africans, we've got to celebrate this young man.
A debut test match for Vernon. That was pretty special.
Yeah, I mean, it's been unbelievable, you know, especially when the Aussies went to bowl. You know, yeah, they took a wicket, you know, virtually every fourth, fifth ball. So, you know, yeah, we were watching and obviously, this game, and based our game plan, you know, as to what they did.
Bridget Hartley is here, obviously carrying with her bronze medal. Bridget, good to see you. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Hey, it's still dangling there and
of
you've
course,
landed
it's
in
still
the
dangling.
Country.
It still feels like I just got it.
Hey, I mean, you made me cry. You know, just, yeah, there was this interview you had straight afterwards with one of our Super Sport reporters, and just the emotion that came through from what you were saying made me kind of like weepy.
It was the most amazing feeling ever. And actually, you're not the only guy who I've heard that cried. So I made a lot of men cry.
So you've got the power, though, to do it.
It seems like it.
What are they saying about that, Daniel? They must be very proud because that's where you kind of took off from.
Yeah, I'm sure they're pretty happy. I haven't been there for a while because spending time training in Pretoria. So So yeah, I'm sure they're all happy.
Right there, I'm hanging on for dear life. I'm going, oh, there's about five, six strokes left. Everything.
You gave it your all.
Matt's screaming, yes, 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 we've got it. We've crossed the line. They didn't know what was happening. He called yes, we've won. And after watching the race, I saw how close it was. I thought we'd won by a lot further.
Really?
Yes, I thought we took about half a length at least. I was like, yes, we crushed them.
At the end of the day, you truly did crush them, and you returned to South Africa with a gold medal. Honestly, truly from TNL, we'd like to say thank you for the gold medal and congratulations.
You've got the job right now. What are the expectations?
Yeah, I think firstly, I must just thank the people for the support. And, you know, wherever I go, the people said, you know, great to be an appointment. How are you going to win? So the expectations is really big. And it's just a big honor. And, you know, you carry the hopes of the whole nation. But I just want to go out there and make the people proud and do my best. And I don't want to make any promises I can't keep. But it will be great to unite the country and make the people proud.
Now, the main reason why we brought you here is that you're going to Barcelona, Spain, to the Cornella Institute. Now, this is a big thing that's happening here. How did that happen? How did they pick you to go there?
Well, I went to this soccer clinic at Balfour Park, where my ex-coach invited me to come just kick a ball around. And then there were a few scouts, and there was an agent who spotted me. And he took me over to Barcelona.
Let me start off with you, Charlie. I mean, the feeling that you've gone this far in the two of you, especially from a South African perspective, you're here now.
Yeah, well, it was a great experience, especially for me as a youngster, to go to Spain to represent South Africa in the national stage, international stage. But I think I did fairly well. I'm very happy that I represented my country, my family, and everyone was supporting me well. So I'm very happy about what happened.
And from your side, Melusa, I know the journey has been long, but in the end, it's what you've been looking for. You must be happy. Your family must be very proud.
Yes, my family is very proud of me because I went there, I did what I can do, and I represented my country very well. And I can say it was a great experience because we did get a chance to meet many people, or few people from Barcelona first team, which is Iniesta, Pedro, Sergio Busquets, and that was a very good experience for me.
Wow. The one thing about TNL is that we take South African music and musicians seriously. We take music from the African continent very seriously because not only have we had musicians from South Africa, we've had artists from the continent itself. And it's always a pleasure when they come through and they go on and succeed.